Remember when you got your first paycheck? The excitement, the freedom, the rush to buy everything you've ever wanted? But then reality hit. Between rent, utilities, groceries, and that cute pair of shoes you just had to have, you found your funds dwindling much faster than expected. You're not alone. Most of us have been there, thinking, "Where did all my money go?" Well, today we have something that can help. Simple lifestyle changes that can leave you with more money at the end of each month. Before we jump into it, I want to know, what's one thing you think eats up most of your monthly budget? Drop your answers in the comments below. And if you're excited about learning ways to save more money, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on more money-saving tips. Stay tuned and let's dive right in. 1. Prepackaged and prepared food. So let's dive right in and talk about the first thing on our list, prepackaged and prepared food. Now, we've all had those days. You're coming back home after a long day at work, you're tired, and the last thing you want to do is cook. That frozen pizza or takeout meal seems like the perfect solution. Quick, convenient, saves time, but have you ever thought about how much it's costing you? According to a study, American households spend about $60 on takeout per week. Don't get me wrong, there's nothing wrong with indulging in a takeout meal or prepackaged food every now and then, but when it becomes a habit, it's not just your wallet that suffers, but also your health. And as cliche as it may sound, health is indeed wealth. Let's take a simple dish as an example, say a chicken Caesar salad. A prepackaged version at a grocery store might cost you about $5. In contrast, if you were to buy fresh ingredients and make the same salad at home, it might cost around $3. Over a year, if you swap just one prepackaged meal per day with a homemade version, you'd save nearly $700. So next time you're about to reach for that prepackaged meal, consider this. Is the convenience worth the cost? 2. Trending or sale items I don't need. Who among us can resist the allure of the words sale or limited edition splashed across a storefront or a website? Admit it, there's a certain thrill in scoring a deal, a rush in being part of the latest trend. But here's the hard truth. Often, we end up spending money on things we don't need merely because they're on sale or are trending. Think about that trendy piece of clothing you bought last season, which now sits forgotten at the back of your closet. That's money that could have been put to better use. The issue here isn't just about spending money, but spending money on things that don't add value to our lives. This doesn't mean we should never partake in sales or buy trending items. The trick is to approach these with a strategic mindset. Make a list before you shop, stick to it, and question every purchase. Do I need it? Will I use it? Is it worth the price? 3. Impulse buys. Have you ever walked into a store intending to buy just one item and walked out with a cart full of things you never planned to purchase? Or perhaps you've clicked on an online ad and ended up buying a product that wasn't even on your radar. If you've experienced this, you're not alone. These are classic examples of impulse buying. Impulse buying is a widespread phenomenon. A survey conducted by CreditCards.com found that 5 in 6 Americans make impulse purchases, with the average person spending over $5,400 a year on unplanned buys. Now imagine if instead giving in to these impulsive purchases, you save that money. In 10 years, you could have an extra $54,000. The power of not giving into impulses, right? So how do we resist this urge? Here are some practical steps you can take. 1. Wait before you buy. If you see something you want but don't need, give it some time. And if you still want it after that period, then consider the purchase. Shop with a list. Having a list can keep you focused on what you need to buy and can help deter impulsive purchases. 3. Avoid shopping when emotional. Shopping when you're stressed, sad, or even overly excited can lead to impulse buying. Try to shop when you're in a balanced state of mind. 4. Unsubscribe from marketing emails. Retailers often send enticing emails about sales and new products. Unsubscribing from these can reduce the temptation to buy. If you find these helpful and want to learn more frugal habits that could save you money and time, make sure to check out the video linked in the description box below. 4. Name brand items. Name brand items, whether it's clothing, food, or electronics, have become synonymous with quality in our minds. We believe that because it's from a well-known company, it must be superior. When we buy name brand items, we're often paying for more than just the product. We're paying for the marketing, the packaging, and the brand's reputation. But if we were to choose function over form, we could save a considerable amount. Now, there will be instances where the brand name item is genuinely superior, and it makes sense to spend a little extra. But those instances are fewer than we think. It's always worth trying a less expensive version. You might find that the difference in quality, if there is any, doesn't justify the price difference. I encourage you to all give it a try. The next time you're shopping, reach for that store brand item instead of the name brand. 5. Cable TV. Once upon a time, cable TV was our window to the world. It brought us news, entertainment, and a way to relax at the end of a long day. But in recent years, the scene has been shifting dramatically, and I believe it's time we talk about it. It's no secret that cable TV can be expensive, but with the rise of streaming platforms like Netflix, Amazon Prime, and Disney Plus, our viewing habits are changing. These platforms are not only cheaper, but offer the convenience of watching our favorite shows whenever we want. Think about it. By saying goodbye to cable TV and subscribing to a couple of streaming services instead, you could save hundreds of dollars per year. And if you're concerned about missing out on live sports or news, there are plenty of affordable streaming services for that too. Not to mention the free content available on platforms like YouTube. I hope this tip makes you ponder and even reconsider your monthly cable subscription. And if you've already cut the cord, share your experience in the comments below. How has it affected your viewing habits and your wallet? 6. Unnecessary subscriptions. Do you remember the last time you checked your bank statement and wondered, what is this monthly charge? If you can relate to this, you're not alone. The digital age has brought us the convenience of subscriptions, but it's also easy to lose track of them. A study conducted by West Monroe found that the average person spends about $237 per month on subscription services. That's almost $2,900 a year, yet many of us are unaware of how much we're actually spending. But how do we fall into this subscription trap? It often starts with a free trial. It's a smart strategy that companies use, banking on the fact that many of us will forget to cancel before the trial period ends. Before we know it, we're locked into a monthly payment for a service we might not even use. The solution seems simple, right? Just cancel any subscriptions you're not using. But often, the idea of combing through our bank statements and tracking down all of our subscriptions can feel overwhelming. Thankfully, there are several apps available that can help with this. They can identify recurring payments and help you decide which subscriptions to keep and which to cancel. I'm not suggesting you cancel all your subscriptions. Many of them likely bring value to your life. It's all about assessing whether they're worth the cost. So your responsibility, should you choose to accept it, is to take control of your subscriptions. Download a subscription tracking app, look at your bank statements, and cancel anything that isn't bringing value to your life. And hey, if you found this tip valuable, don't forget to hit the like button. It helps us create more content like this. 7. Tech upgrades. How many of us are guilty of getting excited about the latest tech gadgets? The new iPhone is out, with its shiny design and impressive specs, and suddenly, our perfectly good old phone doesn't seem so great anymore. But did you know this constant craving for the newest and shiniest tech can put a significant dent in your wallet? Think about it this way. A new high-end smartphone can cost anywhere from $700 to $1,200, or even more. Let's say you decide to upgrade your phone every 2 years. You could be spending an extra $350 to $600 each year just to have the latest model. And that's not even considering other tech items you might be tempted to upgrade, like your laptop, tablet, or smartwatch. Now, I'm not saying you should never upgrade your tech. Technology advances at a rapid pace, and there will come a time when you really need to upgrade. Maybe your current device is low, can't run the latest software, or doesn't support the functionalities you need for work or school. In such cases, an upgrade is justified. But upgrading just because there's a new model out there, even though your current one works just fine, is a spending habit you might want to reconsider. Try to extend the lifespan of your existing devices. Keep them updated with the latest software, use protective cases to prevent physical damage, and get them repaired when necessary instead of immediately opting for a replacement. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. Have you ever regretted an impulsive tech upgrade? Or maybe you found a great way to resist the lure of the latest gadgets? Let me know in the comments below. 8. Bank fees. From ATM fees to maintenance fees, overdraft fees to foreign transaction fees, it seems like we're constantly shelling out money just for the privilege of having a bank account. But here's the thing, a lot of these fees are avoidable if you're willing to put in a little bit of effort. Let's start with ATM fees. These pesky little charges can sneak up on you every time you withdraw money from an ATM that's not affiliated with your bank. The solution? Plan your cash withdrawals ahead of time and only use your bank's ATMs. If that's not always possible, consider switching to a bank that reimburses ATM fees or doesn't charge them at all. Next up, monthly maintenance fees. Many banks charge a monthly fee for maintaining your account, but most of them will waive this fee if you meet certain criteria, like maintaining a minimum balance or setting up a direct deposit. If your bank doesn't offer such waivers, it might be time to shop around for a bank that does. Overdraft fees can be particularly nasty. often costing upwards of $30 each time you overspend your account. The solution here is simple: opt out of overdraft protection. Yes, it means your card will be declined if you don't have enough funds, but it's better than being hit with a hefty fee. Plus, it encourages you to keep a close eye on your account balance, which is never a bad thing. Foreign transaction fees are another unnecessary expense you can avoid. If you frequently travel or shop online from international retailers, consider getting a credit card that doesn't charge foreign transaction fees. There are plenty of options out there, so do your research. Let's not forget about interest charges on credit cards. These can quickly add up if you're not careful. Best way to avoid them? Pay off your balance in full each month. If that's not possible, at least try to pay more than the minimum to minimize the interest charges. It's not about depriving yourself, it's about making smart decisions that help your money work for you, not against you. So the next time your bank tries to charge you a fee, take a moment to ask yourself if it's really necessary. More often than not, you'll find that it's not. 9. Late charges. It's a busy week, you're juggling 1,000 tasks, and before you know it, you've missed a payment deadline and are hit with a late charge. It's an easy mistake to make, but it's also one that can have serious consequences for your finances. Late charges often seem insignificant, maybe $15 here, $25 there, but let's say you make a late payment on a credit card and you're hit with a $25 fee. That's $25 you're paying for nothing more than the privilege of paying your bill late. If you do that once a month, that's $300 per year wasted on late charges. Now imagine if that money was put towards savings or investments instead. Over a period of 10 years, assuming a modest 5% return rate, that would amount to over $4,000. It's clear that these small, unnecessary fees can eat into our savings in a big way over time. How to avoid these late charges? One of the most effective strategies is to automate your payments. Most banks and service providers offer an auto-pay feature that allows you to schedule your payments in advance. Another strategy is to align your due dates. If you have multiple bills coming in at different times of the month, it can be easy to lose track. In some cases, if you're late with a payment, it can be worth calling the company and asking them to waive the late fee. This might not always work, especially if you're frequently late, but if you have a good payment history, they might be willing to give you a pass. If you're interested in learning more about proper money management, check out the link in the description. Remember that these small spending habits can make a big difference in your financial health. I hope this video has given you some ideas on how you can save money by cutting out unnecessary expenses. If you have any tips of your own, or if there's something else you'd like us to cover in a future video, please let us know in the comments. And don't forget, if you found this video useful, hit that like button and be sure to subscribe for more content like this. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.